Hello, welcome back to BCC broadcast. Today we are going to talk about the configuration of router via remote location with the help of Telnet. My name is Amarnath Mishra and I welcome warmly all of you to Bluecrest College for the next episode of configuration of router for Telnet configuration. So here you can see that the connection is already there. We have already seen earlier also the router connected as a console port. Network cable is connected to that and it is connected to the USB port for the system. And we have connected this wire. This is a console cable and we will start the router over here. When we start the router, it initializes the router, then it will boot the router. After booting, we will see the commands, how it has been configured. So this is the port, console port is connected to the router and it has a console cable which is connected to the USB port of my desktop, which will be configured via command line. Continuation of the configuration for Telnet, we have the computer management where you can see the device manager, and in the device manager you will be able to see the port number over here, that is communication port, which is serial to USB converter and it is being connected to the COM port 12, and this port is basically connected to the router console port. And we have identified this port number from the router and the PCs. So now we are going to configure via the emulator application that is called PuTTY. So here is my PuTTY and we will be connecting with the serial port, that is serial, and it is communication port is 12, and we'll make the appearance little bit bigger font so that it will be visible. So it will be like, let's say 14, and we'll open this. This is a PuTTY, that is the emulator application which has been ready for the router configuration. So you can see that router is ready. So we have to go to the no, that means we can check the router interface, that is it will be in the privilege mode. It will be in the user mode. This is the user mode. You can see that the greater than symbol of router is user mode. So when we move to the next mode, that is the privilege mode, we have to put the command that is called enable. When we put the enable command, you can see that the prompt has been changed to the hashtag prompt. It is a privilege mode. So if I want to configure anything, I have to go to the global configuration mode. So I'll provide the command that is called config terminal, con config terminal, configure terminal. So when we come to the configure terminal, you can see that the prompt has been changed to the global configuration mode. In the global configuration mode, we have to provide first the host name. So you will see the name of the router will change here. So we'll provide host name as a Bluecrest. So you can see the host name has been changed from router to Bluecrest. So now first of all we'll configure the router interface IP address. So we'll move to the interface, that is interface fast ethernet, that is 0/0, that is the first port of the ethernet port, and we'll configure the IP address, that is for the fast ethernet. So for IP address 192.168.10.1, that is the router gateway address will be there, and subnet mask of class C, that is 255.255.255.0. We'll put the no shutdown commands for the port to be up. So you can see that the port will become up and we'll exit from the port. So we have came back to the interface, from the interface to the global configuration mode. Now we are going to configure the telnet. So for telnet, we have a command that is called line vty, and then you have to enable the number of telnet ports, that is 0 to 5. That means total number will be 6 port is enabled. Now if you say the login command, it will show you that how many port is active. So you can see that the login command has been set all the 6 port up. So that is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now we'll put the password for the telnet. Password is telnet. So it has been configured. So we'll put exit command to come out from the telnet. So we have configured, the telnet is already set. So now we have to do one more thing, that is we have to set the configuration for user to access. So see, we have to go to the system, to the control panel, so that you can access the router from the Ethernet port instead of console port. So we have to go to control panel. So we'll say that Windows R control. When you come to the control panel, you have to go to the program and features tab. In program and features tab, you will see that turn Windows features on and off. When you come to the turn Windows features on and off, there you will see there is a telnet client services is there. So you have to enable this service. If you don't enable this service, your system will not be able to access telnet. So you have to first enable this service to your computer, and after that you have to go to the command line from the computer. So we'll go to command prompt cmd and we'll try to access our router. So before accessing router, we have to configure the IP address of our system local area connection. Okay, so now we'll go to ncpa.cpl so that it will open my network interface tab. So here we will configure the Ethernet. So we'll enable and we'll go to configure the IP address. So we'll move to the TCP/IP protocol version 4, go to properties, we'll configure the IP address as a 192.168.10.10.2. That is the, because 10.1 is the router gateway address and 10.2 is the host address, and we'll put the gateway address 192.168.10.1. So that is the router IP address. Okay, so we'll click OK, we'll close it. Now we will go to the command prompt and we'll try to do access telnet from the PC, and this is via the Ethernet port. It is not via console cable. So we can access my router through the remote location via Ethernet network, because it is when your router is residing at the remote location. Generally what happens when we access the router, the console cable is basically used for the local administrative access and configuration. So that it is not best practice that every time we should use the console cable to access the router. So that is why we configured the telnet so that we can access our router from the remote location, any part of the globe, any part of the world. So let's see, we will check the telnet now. So we will test the telnet is working or not. So we'll see that telnet space then router IP address 192.168.10.1, and you see it is asking me the password. So this is the password which we have just now we have set, that is the password is telnet. So you can see the password is here, telnet. So we'll provide this password, so telnet, and you see we have got the Bluecrest. And you have just seen that we have changed the host name from router to Bluecrest. So see here, This is the Bluecrest name. We have given the host name, and it is prompting me here the Bluecrest. So that means this is my router. So this is the configuration of Telnet, and we can access the Telnet also from the laptop, from the PC, from the remote location. So I hope you have understand how to configure the Telnet via command line. So it is used to connect the router from the remote location, and hope you have enjoyed the session. So feel free to contact us, Bluecrest College, that is 77 Wilkinson Road, and if you want to feel the devices, please visit to our center. Thank you very much.